right. I want to see you kill it today. Let's go in there and crush this. Oh, good luck! Hey, don't worry about it. That's why it's called training. Great. Hey, great. Great boxing damage. Okay? Good job. Good. Good work with the hands. Yes, I love it. She's starting to fall apart, right? Okay, let's go. Got 30 seconds. Let's go. Today, I want to see you sharp and quick. Good work. Hey, good job today. You really crushed it out there. Beautiful combination. Yes, keep it up. Put the pressure on her. You work with your hands. Starting to fall apart. Good, good, good. You got 30. Let's go. Oh, wow. Wow. That punch damaged her. Let's do more of that. Let's do more of that. Excellent job today. Better than last time, and it'll be better next time. Today, I want to see you sharp and quick. Oh, you look like a champion in there. I want to see you kill it today. Let's go in there and crush it. Ah. Beautiful combination. Yes, keep it up. Put the pressure on her. Hey, you're coming along really well. Here we go, baby. That's a combo. Come on. Boxing damage. Good job. 20 seconds. Give me all you got. Nice kickboxing. All right? Keep building up that damage. Here we go. Great job in there. You land volume. Time to burn and get after it. Here we go. Nice work in there. I want to see more work here. More work. Don't worry about it. There's always tomorrow. All right. Let's see what you got today. Speed and power. That's it. Combination. Yes, keep it up. Put the pressure on her. There it is. Push! Push now! Alright! That was good! Definitely making some progress. Hey, let's go in there and get after it. There we go. Just like that. Again. Awesome job. Let's move on. Right, great job, but I need... Speed, timing, reaction. That's the goal today. Bang! Nice! Nice, nice. Really great job today.
Coming up next, a matchup for the UFC Women's Bantamweight Division title. All right, here she is, the former UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion, Holly Holm. It was Melbourne, Australia. It was UFC 193, November 15th of 2015, when Holly Holm effectively changed her life forever.
Holly Holm changed her life, but she changed the landscape of mixed martial arts.
Yes.
She showed that Ronda Rousey was not this unbeatable fighter that everybody thought she was to be. Went out there, set her traps with that lead left hand, used her footwork and movement to walk Rousey right into a beautiful head kick that finished the fight. A multiple-time boxing champion, amateur kickboxing background, Holly Holm is just truly the professional.
And that Rousey win, still one of the biggest upsets, betting odds or otherwise, in UFC history. Well, I'm not sure if she's a third-degree or a fourth-degree Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt. All I know is that you are in imminent danger every time she closes the distance.
Oh, the belt color hasn't changed, John, but they are just adding stripe after stripe after stripe. She's got so many stripes on her Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt that it's unbelievable. And because of that ability to do Jiu-Jitsu at such a high level, it's almost like you're going into biology class whenever you go on the ground with her. Because as you're thinking, if I do step one to get to step two, she's already on step five.
Right.
She's working on the finish before you even understand that you're in danger. The quick strike ability in the jiu-jitsu is something not many people possess.
I cheated to pass my biology final in college. I wish there was a way to cheat in jiu-jitsu, but she doesn't need to. Big spot for her here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Dan Mergliotta. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out arena in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. Championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This woman is a boxer, holding a professional record of 18 wins, 7 losses. She stands 5 feet 8 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Albuquerque, New Mexico, USA, presenting the challenger, Holly the Preacher's Daughter. And now, introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This woman is a jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 19 wins, no losses. She stands 5 feet 7 inches tall, weighing in at 131 pounds. Presenting a reigning, defending, undisputed UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion of the world.
UFC Championship. Well, she's been with the man at all times.
Bam, bam.
Championship fight. This is the fight that fans really wanted to see. Consensus top two 135ers in the world. The champion doesn't necessarily see it that way. She believes she is the level up. She has defended the title in the past. That is a great source of confidence for her as she tries to remain the hunted here at 135 pounds. Ooh, beautiful connection by her on that punch.
She's so fast when she throws.
All right, here we go. First round is underway. You know about her jiu-jitsu game. She is a submission specialist, so you don't want to hang out on the feet here for too long. She's got to go for the early takedown. Let's see how quickly she tries to change up this one and get this fight down to the canvas. Oh, pretty good series of punches by her there. She certainly has found the range early tonight.
She can box anybody in the world, and she's showing that tonight. tight that leg.
And landing some nasty strikes.
Oh, big Superman punch there.
Big kick land.
All right, so once again, the fighters engage in the clinch. We'll see who will have the upper hand here, champ.
There are so many options to dictate and control this exact position. Who is going to take advantage of it?
Oh, and she connects there. Beautiful punch.
Great punch. So what's next? What is she going to use to follow it up?
Man, how good is her jab? And there it is again. So that jab has been in her opponent's face from the opening.
It is crazy to watch this, John. It's amazing for us to sit here and watch someone with an understanding of the striking and an understanding of the jab being first, as she is showing us tonight.
Great vision, great defense. He's had a huge strike right there, DC.
Great shot landed. Now she got to chase her down. Get another one off to finish the fight. Great punch.
They continue to exchange. Holly Holmes' lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swell-up. Oh, she lands another hook there. That's been the storyline in this round. She told us on Thursday she felt like that weapon would be wide open, and that's exactly the way it's played out.
That's exactly what she anticipated doing, because she saw a weakness in her opponent's defenses in seeing the hooks. So she's wrapping around the high guard and landing and really turning her whole body into that punch. Big
leg.
What a great job of finding such a massive shot.
All right, so she's making her way back to the stool, kind of shaking her head. Thought maybe that knockdown would have produced a finish. Not so much.
She's a little discouraged right now because she thought the fight was over. But if you know her, if you spend any time with her, you understand that she's a smart fighter, and she will get right back to doing what she needs to do to win this fight.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about right there. I need another one, just like that, okay? You won that round, no wavering.
You ready? You ready? So fight.
Gets caught with that punch. Don't be afraid to get that head off the center line. Oh, can you hear the reaction from the crowd? As see the seminal blow of this fight this way.
Yeah, man, she landed a massive.
Goes down again. Fight's over.
Oh, my goodness.
That was a good stoppage by the referee. She was not effectively defending herself, and the opponent was doing some real damage. It became a dangerous situation. I think it's the right call by the official, and she will live to fight another day. All right, we take a look back at some of the pictures from this one, and she had it all going on tonight, but certainly her boxing was on point.
Her boxing always is what allows her to dictate the pace of fights. Finally, she landed the strike that ended the night of her opponent.
The official decision is in. That's where we find Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliano has called a stop to this contest at 42 seconds of round number two, declaring the winner by knockout and still the undisputed UFC bantamweight champion of the world, Bam Bam.
All right, so we congratulate the still UFC bantamweight champion, and it was the way she got it done tonight, DC, by knockout, that's really going to resonate with fight fans around the world.
I mean, she's just the best. She is just the best. That's the only word to describe this fighter. She is just so good at everything in terms of mixed martial arts. She's a long-reigning champion. All hail the queen.
This round, I just want to see heavy punches. Let it go. Yeah, that's it. Work on that boxing damage. Love it. Punch! Yes, 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 yes! What a bruise! Let's go, baby, let's go! Nice punch! Yeah, nice punch! She felt that one. Perfect block. Don't stop now. 30 on the clock. Hey, good job today. You really crushed it out there. Excellent job today. Better than last time, and it'll be better next time. Okay, I want you to push today. Give it everything you got. Let's go. Dominated today. Good work. Excellent. Excellent work. Combination. Yes, keep it up. Put the pressure on her. Let's go. 30 on the clock. Beautiful combination. Keep it up. Put the pressure on her. Put the pressure on her. Let's go. Good job, Anita. Your kicks are... Speed, timing, reaction. That's the goal today. Great combo. Keep it up. Great job today. Today, let's go in there and get after it. There it is. That's the one. Listen, you fight like that, you're gonna dominate. Guaranteed. All right, pick up your pace a little, okay? More volume. Don't stop now. 30 on the clock. Get heavy in there, let's sag. Nice work, I like it. You stayed heavy on top and controlled your sparring partner with eat. My clock doesn't stop until you submit her. Let's go. Excellent job. There we go. That's the position we want. Let's go. Good work. Next set now. Nice. Perfect. Nice work. Lock her down. Oh, that was pretty good. Beautiful. Beautiful. Yes, focus. Lock it down. Focus on locking it down. Come on, you can't just lay on top. Got it? You gotta create actions. 10 seconds left. Push, push, push. Nice work. Nice work. Now focus on locking that in. Time to burn and get after it. Here we go. Beautiful combination. Yes, keep it up. Put the pressure on her. Today. I'll call it out, you throw. Listen. You keep trending like that, and no one will catch you. Remember, repetition is key, and it always pays off. So let's go. Don't stop now, you got 30 seconds. Your next opponent is not going to be able to keep up with you. All right, now that's some... This round, I just want to see heavy punches. Let it go. Great. Hey, great. Great boxing damage. Okay? Good job. MMA boxing damage. Good job. Now that's the aggression I want to see in your next fight. Great job. Nice boxing, yes. Nice boxing. Now, just keep building up that damage. Let me see that. Let's go. Let's go. 30 on the clock.
All right, coming up next, it is our main event, a matchup for the UFC Women's Bantamweight title. Well, this is a belt that has changed hands quite a bit, and this number one bantamweight contender believes it will again here tonight as she makes the walk for this title fight. She believes this title shot should have come earlier. She's not caught up in all that now. Hasn't been during fight week. She's focused on the champion, and you see her staring her down right now. Crowd going crazy. She believes she is the best bantamweight in the world and believes in a matter of moments here, she will be the new champion. So here she is, the undisputed UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion. How about the confidence as she makes the walk here tonight? She wants to get in there, take care of business, and go eat some buffalo wings in the back. She's been the best 135er in the world now for some time. Another title defense, what's in front of her? She doesn't try to make the moment too big. And even though the challenger has a lot of momentum here tonight, she knows she's the hunted for a reason and is looking to prove that she is still the best in the world at 135. Our tale of the tape for this, our main event of the evening. So more than 15 years, the gap in age between these two fighters with similar height and some differences in reach. To get us started with the official introductions, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening.
And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Herb Dean.
This is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the Honda Center in Anaheim, California. It's time! Five rounds world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner.
This woman is a kickboxer holding a professional record of 12 wins, 7 losses, and 1 draw. She stands 5 feet 5 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Campina Grande, Paraíba, Brazil, presenting the challenger, Beth Pitbull Correa. And now, introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This woman is a jiu-jitsu fighter holding a professional record of 20 wins, no losses. She stands 5 feet 7 inches tall, weighing in at 131 pounds. Presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion of the World, Bam Bam.
All right, this is for the championship. You've been giving your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves. Let's make it official.
Ready. Ready to fight.
All right, so round one is underway. After her last fight, you heard Bruce Buffer say, and still UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion. She is trying to have him say it again here tonight. She is unquestionably the number one 135-pound fighter in the world. She has successfully defended this belt in the past, and she believes here tonight she's on a different level than the number one contender. We'll see if she can prove it here and turn those words into actions as round one gets underway. All right, first round is underway. Many people expected a big storyline, and this one would be...
Oh! Oh! Oh, my goodness!
Oh, straight right! Oh, nice punch there by Kohei. Well, she continues to leave that head open, and she paid for it there. She's almost moving into the strike. She hasn't changed up her tempo, and she continues to keep her head on that.
Oh! She is such a diverse striker that...
Oh!
That's how you finish your fight.
That's Kohei getting touched here repeatedly with these ground-and-pound strikes from the top. Referee's not going to bail you out. Man, does she throw these hands seamlessly and easily, connects with another series of punches there.
She is one of the best boxers in the UFC, and this is the reason why we say it every time she fights.
Nice shot over the top there. Oh! Big shots exchanged in the pocket there.
There's no tell on that leg kick.
She slips that left hand there.
Big punch from the clinch.
Oh!
Can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish.
Whoa! Back to the feet. Oh, big left. Well, she whiffs on the straight right hand, and she connects with a punch there, champ. Oh! And just like that, the fight is over. If you're trying to send a message to the rest of this division, that is how you send it. So a near-perfect shot for her to end the fight. She had this crowd behind her all night long, and I'm not sure how many other fighters in this division could have absorbed that strike and stayed in the fight. A near-perfect land to get the knockout win here tonight. So there she is, folks, a woman who now needs no introduction, the UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion of the World, getting it done by knockout and with major style points here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 29 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, and still the undisputed UFC Bantamweight Champion of the World, Bam-Bam.
All right, so we congratulate the still UFC Bantamweight Champion, and it was the way she got it done tonight, DC, by knockout, that's really going to resonate with fight fans around the world.
I mean, she's just the best. She is just the best. That's the only word to describe this fighter. She is just so good at everything in terms of mixed martial arts. She's a long-reigning champion. All hail the queen.